Automations are how Ontraport, you know, automates things, from lead follow-up and management to streamlining internal processes of all kinds. These are at the center of how your Ontraport account can help you scale up your business. Once you have a basic understanding of the automation builder, you'll be able to quickly design, launch, and optimize sophisticated marketing funnels and business processes, and then turn them on autopilot. In this video, I'm going to give you a quick big picture overview of automations, and then we'll dive deeper in the next series of videos. Let's get started. First, what do we mean when we say automations? Automations are workflows built in a map-style layout tool that allow you to build a series of steps to systemize processes in your business. They're made up of several different element types, categorized into triggers, actions, and filters, all of which we'll cover in depth in later videos. These elements are organized from the top of the page to the bottom as you add them. You can do that by clicking on these plus icons or clicking on the What Happens Next box here. You can also move or copy elements in groups of elements by dragging them using the arrows and dropping them on those same pluses. Once you publish your automation, it becomes live, and that's when the magic really starts to happen. Okay, so here's how this works. The triggers on your map have some settings, and the system uses those settings in order to monitor all of your contacts to watch for when one of your contacts does something that matches the setting in a trigger. That contact is then added at the trigger and immediately starts moving down the path you've laid out from top to bottom through the elements on your map. So for example, if you have a trigger that says when someone fills out a form or when someone purchases a product, whenever one of those actions takes place, the contact who triggered it will be added to the top of that map here on the trigger. Pretty soon, you'll have contacts all over your map, and you can see where contacts are specifically located by looking at the numbers in performance mode here. You can even click on a specific spot to see a list of those contacts. Now, before we dive into the nitty-gritty details of automations, there are a few more things to know. First, while it's mostly true that contacts start at the top and work their way down, that's not always the case. There are a lot of times where you'll need to add forks in the road so that you can add elements called conditions which split contacts down two paths, the yes path and the no path, depending on whether or not they meet the conditions that you've set. In some situations, you'll also want to have contacts jump from one spot to another when something specific happens. This is called goals. This feature allows you to deliver the exact right experience for each contact depending upon what you know about them and what they do. So for example, if somebody buys something, you're probably going to want to stop following up with marketing emails and just deliver the product that you promised. And you'll use a goal element to have contacts jump around the map like that. Plus, there are go-to elements, which can drop contacts anywhere. So it's not always strictly top to bottom. You can get pretty fancy with all this stuff. Second, because we've described this as a map, it's tempting to imagine that a contact can only be on the map at one place at one time, but that's not really true. You know that in real life, your customers often require multiple things at once, things like receiving your newsletter and having their products delivered at the same time. We've built automations to support those needs. So depending on your settings, it's entirely possible that a contact may be in multiple places in an automation at once. And this gives you all kinds of powerful possibilities and some great reporting options that you'll learn about later. Third, let's draw your attention to the element settings over here. There are a whole bunch of them, and they're really important because they'll change how your whole automation runs. Make sure to pay special attention to the settings and triggers and goals, which are explained in detail in the upcoming lessons. Finally, although we're only going to talk about contacts as an example throughout this series of lessons for simplicity's sake, it's important to know that contacts are not the only record type that can use automations. In Ontraport, you can store and manage all kinds of data, and you can use automations to streamline processes for any of them. So for example, you might be a vet, and you might want to store records about each of your pets, and then maybe automate a reminder to that pet's owner on each of their birthdays. This is really powerful stuff, and I'm going to explain it more later on. Some automation maps can be as simple as a series of emails or designed to just update a field. Or they can get really sophisticated and involve all kinds of different actions and processes. But the power they put into your hands as a business builder is awesome. So it's really important that you take the time to learn this part of the platform in detail. Using automations will serve you well in your business and make it so you can quickly turn your ideas into reality. Now that you have a foundational understanding of automations, let's take a detailed tour of the automation builder. Then later, we'll dive into details for each of the element types and focus on reporting in performance mode and other advanced topics.